Buenas tardes a todos. Good afternoon. Bienvenidos. Welcome on this happy day when the Holy Spirit is going to come upon these young men and women, go into their hearts and into their souls and enliven them. But I have to make a disclaimer first. I'm not a bishop. I never have been a bishop. I don't want to be a bishop. But until June 30th, because of the pandemic, I have the mandate to confirm the young boys and girls, the young men and women in our parish. And so to make that perfectly clear, you guys remember the song La Bamba? Remember that song? Okay. Yo no soy el obispo. Yo no soy el obispo, soy padre Stan, soy padre Stan, soy padre Stan. No obispo, sacerdote. Okay, yeah. Continuamos la misa en este espíritu, en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo, del Espíritu Santo. Amen. El Señor esté con todos ustedes. In order to celebrate our Mass today worthily and joyously, let us call to mind our sins and turn to our God, who alone can heal us.
Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Cristo Jesús, tú fuiste enviado para sanar los corazones. Cristo, ten piedad.
Cristo, ten piedad.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and welcome us all one day to everlasting life. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
own faith and strengthened by the power of his love, we may come to the measure of the full stature of Christ. Grant this and all good and holy things through Christ the Lord. Amen. With us, Darcy, I commit him to it. Please be seated.
Lo mismo que nosotros, y los mandó bautizar en el nombre reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Blessed does. Estimados hermanos y hermanas en Cristo, estamos reunidos aquí en este templo para celebrar el sacramento de la confirmación. Este sacramento que será recibido por estos jóvenes que se han preparado para este momento, como su nombre lo indica, confirma lo que ustedes, padres y padrinos, han pedido al Señor cuando estos jóvenes fueron bautizados. Ellos, cuando fueron bautizados, recibieron el Espíritu Santo, el Espíritu de Dios que está en cada uno de nosotros y que nos ayuda en este camino por este mundo en el que Dios nos ha puesto. Pero el sacramento de la confirmación, de alguna manera, no solo confirma, sino refuerza las gracias y bendiciones del sacramento del bautismo. Porque hoy, a través de este sacramento, el Espíritu Santo nuevamente es recibido, pero de una manera especial y misteriosa, por el cual los siete dones del Espíritu Santo son impartidos en cada uno de estos jóvenes que hoy reciben el sacramento de la confirmación. Y estos dones son dones que nosotros necesitamos, que todos necesitamos, pero en especial estos jóvenes que hoy se confirman. ¿Por qué? Porque ellos están en la edad de la adolescencia, cuando necesitan de todas las gracias y bendiciones y regalos que Dios nos da para enfrentar este mundo en el que nosotros vivimos. Por eso es importante el sacramento de la confirmación. Es un sacramento que se recibe una sola vez en la vida, porque una vez que ya tenemos el Espíritu de Dios dentro de nosotros, no lo perdemos como podríamos perder la gracia santificante que recuperamos a través del sacramento de la reconciliación, más conocido como confesión. Así que estos jóvenes que están presentes aquí han sido instruidos muy eficazmente por nuestros catequistas, especialmente la señora Cookie, que ha trabajado en este último año con ellos. El año precedente fue el padre Stan y la señorita Aileen, la directora de nuestra escuela, que también nos introdujo al sacramento de la confirmación. Pero a mí me gustaría más dirigir este mensaje a los padres y padrinos de estos niños, porque ellos necesitan de su apoyo, especialmente de los padrinos. Los padrinos que presentan a estos jóvenes para ser confirmados fueron elegidos porque estos jóvenes los consideran a ustedes como un modelo de fe. Así que si ustedes son un modelo de fe para estos jóvenes, ellos esperan, y con mucha razón, de que ustedes los acompañen en este camino, en el encuentro del Señor. Y tal vez algún día eso se manifieste a través de un consejo, o se manifieste a través de una palabra de aliento, se manifieste a través de tal vez una enseñanza, algo que los edifique como seres humanos y cristianos. Así que es una responsabilidad muy grande la que los padrinos y madrinas están presentes hoy toman delante del altar del Señor. Y los padres, por supuesto, como los primeros catequistas, acompañan ese esfuerzo, acompañan este crecimiento espiritual de estos jóvenes. Estos jóvenes hoy no se gradúan de la Iglesia Católica. Empiezan un nuevo capítulo en su vida, por el cual, si desean continuar en este camino de bendiciones y gracias que Dios nos regala, es importante de que permanezcan en el amor de Dios, como dice el Evangelio de hoy, permanezcan en mi amor. Todos nosotros tenemos que estar conectados a Jesús por ese amor que Él nos da, porque ese amor nos da vida, ese amor vivifica esa sangre que corre por nuestras venas para que nosotros una y otra vez estemos frente al Señor y compartamos la presencia del Señor a través de la Eucaristía. Así que Padre, padrinos, jóvenes que hoy se confirman, felicidades en este día, felicidades por este logro, pero recuerden, hoy comienza un nuevo capítulo en sus vidas y mucha gente va a depender de ustedes, porque ustedes son el futuro de la Iglesia. Que así sea. Father Stan, Pastor of Our Lady of the Snows, I present to you these young men and women of Our Lady of the Snows Parish who have completed a period of preparation for the Sacrament of Confirmation. They have deepened their knowledge of Jesus Christ by studying the truths of our faith. They have been strengthened by God's grace in the sacraments and have been supported by the prayers and example of our parish community. I now ask you to celebrate the completion of their initiation into the life of Christ and to seal them with the gifts of the Holy Spirit. These candidates have been prepared to be fully initiated into the community of the Church. Upon inquiry among their parents, sponsors, Ms. Cookie, the catechist, I testify that they are ready to celebrate this sacrament. On behalf of our parish community, I present these candidates for the sacrament of confirmation.
Thank you, Deacon Franco. I know that they're ready because I know some of the people who prepared them, and I know that they got a quality preparation for this day, and I know that all of you had some hand in that as well. A couple of orders of business before I get into my homily. First of all, because we're not able to have a practice, so everything is new to you, so I'd like to just let you know kind of what's going to happen, and then forget about it, because we're gonna kind of lead you through this. So don't worry about what should I do, where should I go. First of all, most of you I see already have your stoles, and I believe you received a certificate when you came in, and I hope you checked those and made sure all the information was correct on them. Two of you are also going to be making your first Holy Communion today. Sulema Sanchez and Brian Ramirez are also going to be receiving our Lord in Holy Communion for the first time today, and we are going to call you up first when it comes to communion time. If you have any articles to be blessed, we're going to do that after communion. Deacon and I have holy water up here. We'll go among you, and all you need to do is hold La Medalla, La Biblia, Rosario, cualquier cosa in your hands, and we will bless them, and we may bless you also in the process of that. There will be pictures taken in addition to Gabriel live streaming, and this is going to be posted later on Facebook and YouTube. We have Mr. Ray Sanchez who's here, and he is going to be taking two pictures that you can purchase if you desire afterwards, and they're two for $20. The first picture is going to be right here when you are being confirmed. As the oil is being placed on your forehead, there'll be a picture taken, and then when that's finished, you're going to turn around with your sponsor, And it'll take one from the center aisle of you, your sponsor, myself, and Deacon Branko. So that's the basic format of it. When it comes time for the confirmation, you'll be called up by name. You'll be called up by name. Miss Cookie's going to call your name. One by one, you'll come up with your sponsor, And then we're going to do two things a little bit differently. Remember, 1 year ago, we couldn't do any of this. 1 year ago, the churches were not open. We were in the middle of the pandemic. Now we can do something, but some things have to be modified a little bit. So instead of dipping my thumb in the oil and going like this on your head, we're going to use a cotton ball. Every one of you is going to have an individual cotton ball that I will dip in the holy oil. And when I seal you with the oil, I will say this: be sealed with the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And your response is, amen. Can we try that? Be sealed with the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And then, normally the bishop would shake your hand and say, peace be with you. We can't do that either. So I will just say, peace be with you. And your response to that is, and with your spirit. And then at that point, you'll turn around for the second picture. We're going to renew your baptismal promises. This journey began when you were baptized. It began when you were baptized. Your padrinos and padres answered these questions for you back then. Today you're going to do it on your own. And Deacon is going to lead us through those. And then the actual calling down of the Holy Spirit is called the imposición de las manos. So Deacon and I will hold our hands down over you, those who are about to be burned, and we will literally call the Spirit down upon you like we heard in the reading today. And then we'll proceed with the confirmation and then Mass as usual. If I could have my crozier, Miguelito. I never had a chance to go to bishop school, so this is we're kind of winging it as we go along, but that's okay. Those young men and women who are going to be confirmed today, I want you to take one image home with you, and that's the image that was in the first reading today. It was read in Spanish, but what it said was this: as Peter was speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon them. It didn't blow around like a little breeze and enter into their soul or enter into their heart. It wasn't a little bird twinkling above them. It wasn't a tongue of fire like a Pentecost. But the Holy Spirit fell upon them. You know, in a couple of days, maybe it happened already. I wasn't paying too much attention to the news, but there's some big satellite up in the sky that's coming crashing down to Earth. It's going to fall upon us. That's what I'd like you to imagine the Holy Spirit doing to you today, falling upon you and changing you forever. Because that's exactly what happened to the people in the Acts of the Apostles. Once that Spirit came to them, there was no going back. There was no turning back. They were different people, and they were ready to go out and conquer the world. And I want you to know that you're the generation that we're counting on. You're the generation that old people like me are going to depend on. Because when you pick up a newspaper or turn on the news, we see some pretty scary stuff out there. We're going to depend on you, Spirit-filled, maybe beginning today, maybe it's already in you, to go out and make your mark on the world and plant the seeds of goodness and love, little by little by little. apostle says, you know someone who has the Spirit. You recognize it immediately. You can tell by the people that they are, by the way they treat each other, by how kind they are, by the joy that's in their heart, by the peace that they have in their soul, no matter what's going on, by the kindness that they exude, by the way they treat the people that society kicks to the curb. That's how you want to be recognized. Those are the kind of people that I want to hang around with because it's catchy. When you hang around with people who are Spirit-filled, that Spirit rubs off on you too. And that's exactly what we hope is going to happen today. So those of you who are about to be confirmed, please stand. Just los candidatos de confirmación de pie, por favor. Solo ellos. And we're going to renew your baptismal promises now. So I ask Deacon Franco to go up here with me. And we're going to renew the promises that were made at your baptism. And those of you who are here, if you want to answer along with these young men and women, you can feel free to support them with our responses.
The response for the promises in English is I do, and in Spanish it's going to be sí. Okay, en español, por favor, respondan sí a cada invocación. Do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Creen en el Espíritu Santo, Señor y Dador de vida, que hoy les va a ser comunicado de un modo singular por el sacramento de la confirmación, como fue dado a los apóstoles el día de Pentecostés?
Sí.
Creen en la Santa Iglesia Católica, en la comunión de los santos, en el perdón de los pecados, en la resurrección de la carne y en la vida eterna?
Sí.
Esta es nuestra fe. Esta es la fe de la Iglesia que nos gloriamos de profesar en Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
Muy bien.
And now Deacon and I are going to, in silence, call down the Holy Spirit upon you. And I ask all of you who are here to do the same in your heart and in your soul. If you want to, if you feel like extending your hand up toward them to call the Spirit down upon them, let it fall upon them, just like it did to the people when Peter was speaking in the Acts of the Apostles. So, Holy Spirit, come upon these young men and women. Now I'll pray the prayer. Almighty God, Father of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who brought these, your servants, to new birth by water and by the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin. Send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now after I sanitize my hands, Deacon will get the oils. And when your name is called, if you can come up with your sponsor right here in this area. And Peace be with you.
Thank you.
gifts of the Holy Spirit is with you.
Jose, be sealed with the
estén de pie y continuamos la misa con las intenciones, oraciones de los fieles.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer, or Señor, escucha nuestra oración. That the Catholic Church and the world be enlightened by the Holy Spirit and proclaim the good news with joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Para que las personas que luchan por la paz sean renovadas e inspiren al mundo a buscar la justicia, roguemos al Señor.
Señor, escucha nuestra oración.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Cardinal Supich, Father Stan, Deacon Franco, and all the leaders of the Church, that the Holy Spirit may guide them always, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Por los recién bautizados y confirmados, por los miembros de esta asamblea, por su alimento espiritual, roguemos al Señor.
Señor, escucha nuestra oración.
For those who are sick in any way, that the Holy Spirit will grant them health and courage, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Por nuestros queridos difuntos que descansen en paz, roguemos al Señor.
Señor, escucha nuestra oración.
Ahora tomemos un momento para añadir nuestras intenciones personales. Let us now take a moment to add our own intentions in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. God our Father, hear our prayers. Hear us, God the Son. Holy Spirit, hear our prayers. Mercy on your people, Lord. Amen. Please be seated with us in peace.
Poured out the promised Holy Spirit on your adopted children.
And so now, and for ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out, as together we acclaim.
Los apóstoles y cuantos vivieron en tu amistad,
a través de los tiempos, merezcamos por tu Hijo Jesucristo compartir la vida eterna y cantar tus alabanzas. Por Cristo, con Él y en Él, a ti Dios Padre Omnipotente, en la unidad del Espíritu Santo, todo honor y toda gloria por los siglos de los siglos. Behold the Lamb. Behold the one who takes away the sin of our world. And blessed are they who are called to the table of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
hold it in your hand. Libro, Rosario, Medalla, small children, hold them in your hands and we will bless them with the Easter water. Instruct, O Lord, in your law those who have endowed with the gifts of your Spirit, and nourished by the body of your only begotten Son, that they may constantly show to the world the freedom of being your children, and by their holiness exercise the prophetic mission of your people. Grant this through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
Just a reminder that the pictures, if you want them, are $2 for $20. You can pass through the parking lot outside by the doors to the hall, and I'll be outside as well. We can't linger inside here because the church has to be sanitized again, so right after Mass, follow me out to the parking lot, please, and I'll be out there with the mitre and the crozier if anybody wants to snap a picture with me or with Deacon. El Señor esté con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu. Inclinen sus cabezas para recibir la bendición de Dios y respondan amén a cada invocación.
May God the Father Almighty bless you, whom he has made his adopted sons and daughters, reborn by water and the Holy Spirit, and make you worthy of his love.
Amen.
Amen. May his only begotten Son, who promised that the Spirit would abide in his church, bless you and confirm you by the power in the confession of the one who prayed.
Amen. Amen.
And may the Holy Spirit, who kindles the fire of charity in the hearts of the disciples, bless you and lead you blameless and gathered as one into the joy of the heavenly kingdom.
Amen.
Que la bendición de Dios Todopoderoso, Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo, descienda sobre ustedes hoy y para siempre.
Amén. Hermanos y hermanas, esta celebración ha concluido. Podemos ir en paz. Aleluya, aleluya.
Demos gracias a Dios. Aleluya.
Aleluya.